डिफेंस एक्सरसाइज टेस्ट। सुदर्शन एक्सरसाइज। द इंडियन नेवी कंडक्ट एक्सरसाइज सिंधु सुदर्शन फॉर द ईयर 2019 इन द डेजर्ट ऑफ राजस्थान फ्रॉम नवंबर 29 टू दिसंबर 14 दिसंबर 4 2019। The aim of this exercise is to evaluate the capability of the defense services in an integrated air-land battle. Shakti 2019. Indian and French armies conduct joint counter-terrorism drill under Exercise Shakti 2019 in the Mahajan Field Firing Range in Rajasthan from October 31 to 13 November 2019. सिंधु सुदर्शन सेवन एक्सरसाइज। द स्ट्राइक कॉप्स ऑफ द इंडियन आर्मी हैज कंडक्टेड इट्स सेकेंड फेज ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज नेम्ड सिंधु सुदर्शन सेवन इन राजस्थान फ्रॉम नवंबर 12 टू 18 टू 2019। समुद्र शक्ति। द सेकेंड डिविजनल नेवल एक्सरसाइज समुद्र शक्ति 2019 बिटवीन इंडियन नेवी एंड इंडोनेशियन नेवी वॉज हेल्ड इन द बे ऑफ बंगाल फ्रॉम 6 टू 7 नवंबर 2019। डस्ट लीक 2019। द फर्स्ट एवर इंडिया उज्बेकिस्तान ज्वाइंट मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज डस्ट लीक 2019 वॉज हेल्ड एट चिरचिक ट्रेनिंग एरिया नियर ताशकेंत फ्रॉम November from 4 to 13 November 2019. The exercise enabled sharing for best practices and experiences between the armed forces of the two countries. Sudarshan Chakra Vahini War Exercise. A 2-day long Sudarshan Chakra Vahini War Exercise 2019 of the Indian Navy was held at Jaisalmer Field Firing Range, Rajasthan from 20 to 21 October 2019. IMINEX 2019. The second edition of India-Myanmar Naval Exercise called IMINEX 2019 was held in Visakhapatnam from 19 to 22 October 2019. The exercise was consisted in two phases. The harbor phase included visit to India Naval Units training and maintenance facility at Visakhapatnam. India test fired Prithvi 2 missile. India has successfully test fired indigenously developed nuclear capable Prithvi 2 missile from a mobile launcher from Launch Complex 3 of Chandipur Integrated Test Range ITR in Balasore district of Odisha on November 20 November 2019. It is the surface missile which has a strike range 350 km. It is capable of carrying 500 to 1000 kg of warhead and is powered by liquid propulsion twin engine. Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh launched. The Ministry of Women and Child Development along with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation has launched the Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh BPKK in New Delhi on 18 November 2019. The Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh is a respiratory repository of diverse crops across the 2028 agroclimate zones to help enable better nutritional outcomes. A special winter grade diesel launched. Home Minister Amit Shah has launched a special winter grade diesel for the citizen of Ladakh through video conferencing in New Delhi on 17 October 2019. The winter grade diesel has been developed by the Indian Oil Corporation and is staying unforeseen up to -33 degrees Celsius. It helped to reduce the hardship faced by the local people for transportation and mobility during the harsh winter months. Darjeeling Green and White Tea received GI tag. Two tea varieties of Darjeeling tea, namely green tea and white tea, were registered under the Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999 ऑन 16 नवंबर 2019 दार्जिलिंग प्रोड्यूसेज 85 लाख किलोग्राम्स ऑफ टी ऑफ दिस टी ग्रीन टी कंस्टिट्यूटेड कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स 10 लाख किलोग्राम एंड व्हाइट टी कंस्टिट्यूएंट 1 लाख किलोग्राम इंडिया कंडक्ट्स फर्स्ट नाइट ट्रायल ऑफ द अग्नि 2 मिसाइल DRDO has successfully conducted the first night trial of nuclear capable intermediate range ballistic missile Agni 2 from the Dr. Abul Kalam Azad Island off the Odisha coast on 16 November 2019. The 20 meter long two stage ballistic missile has a launched weight 17 ton and can carry a payload 1000 kg over a distance of 2000 kilometer. Sisri River Bridge inaugurated. Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has inaugurated the Sisri River Bridge at the Lower Dibang Valley in East Siang district of Arunachal Pradesh on 15 November 2019. It is the 200 meter long bridge between the Jonai Pasighat Rangaghat Rowing Road will provide connectivity between Dibang Valley and Siang. It was constructed by Project Brahmanak of Border or Road Organization BRO CJI's office or to come under RTI Supreme Court ruled that the office of CJI of India is a public authority under the Right to Information Act on 13 November 2019 The order was passed by the 5 judges constituency bench led by the Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi with other member including the Justice N.V. Ramana D.Y. Chandrachud, Deepak Gupta and Sanjeev Khanna. Ayodhya case verdict. After about 70 years of legal battle in independent India, the Babri Masjid Janma Bhoomi land dispute of Ayodhya resolved. The Supreme Court has finally delivered its much awaited verdict 9 December 2019 in the landmark Ayodhya Mandir Babri Masjid land title dispute and ruled in favor of the Hindu side with regards to the ownership of the disputed piece of land. The apex court has also ordered the government to allot a 5-acre plot at a prominent place in Ayodhya to the Muslim to construct a new mosque. Kartarpur corridor inaugurated. PM Narendra Modi has inaugurated integrated checkpost of Kartarpur corridor at Dera Baba Nanak in Punjab on 9 November 2019. He also flagged off the first batch of over 500 Indian pilgrims led by Akal Takht Jathedar Gyani Harpreet Singh to Gurudwara Darbar Sahib through the corridor. FSSAI released food safety guidelines for schools. The Food Safety and Standard Authority of India has released the draft regulations titled Food Security and Standard Food Security, Safe Food and Healthy Diets for School Children, Regulation 2019 on 7 November 2019. The draft is a 10-pointer chart that prohibits the sale and promotion of unhealthy food items in schools and nearby locations. Shaila Darpan portal launched. The Union Minister of State for HRD Sanjay Dhotre has launched a Shaila Darpan portal for Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti NVS in New Delhi on 6 November 2019. Shaila Darpan portal is an end-to-end e-governance school automation and management system for Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti. International. WHO declared the global risk for novel coronavirus 2019 in COVID. The World Health Organization has declared the outbreak of novel coronavirus a global health emergency on 30 January 2020 because the outbreak continued to spread outside China. Coronavirus is an umbrella term for the virus that causes the illness ranging from common cold to diseases such as the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and solve the acute respiratory syndrome by 31 January 2020. 213 deaths have been reported and 9,776 confirmed cases. हाइवोन टेलीस्कोप टेलीस्कोप कैप्चर्ड मोस्ट डिटेल पिक्चर ऑफ द सन एट हवाइज डेनियल के इन्योल इन्यूसो टेलीस्कोप हैज कैप्चर्ड द हाईएस्ट एवर रिजोल्यूशन इमेज ऑफ द सोलर सर्फेस ऑन 29 जनवरी 2020. द इमेज शोन द सन्स सर्फेस टू मेड अप ऑफ ए ग्रेनुअल स्ट्रक्चर लाइक न्यूज्ड नज्ड ऑफ गोल्ड ईच अबाउट द साइज ऑफ फ्रेंच से खालिद बिन खलीफा बिन अबुल लाजीज अल थानी अपॉइंटेड एज द न्यू किंग ऑफ कतर से खालिद बिन खलीफा बिन अब्दुल्लाजीज अल थानी हैज बिन अपॉइंटेड एज द न्यू प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ कतर ऑन 28 जनवरी 2020. Along with the position of Prime Minister, he has also taken over the Ministry of Interior. He succeeded the Sheikh Abdullah bin Nasir bin Khalifa Al Thani, who submitted his resignation to the Emir. Switzerland minted world's smallest gold coin. Switzerland state-owned Swiss Mint has minted world's smallest gold coin of 2.96 mm. It means 0.12 inches on 23 January 2020. The coin features a face of scientist Albert Einstein sticking out his tongue. The weight is 0.063 grams and has a nominal value one by six Swiss franc. It means $0.26. Corruption Perceptions Index 2019. Transparency International has released the Corruption Perceptions Index 2019 during the annual meeting of the World Economic Forum in Davos on 23 January 2020. Denmark and New Zealand have cornered the top spot, followed by the Finland, Singapore, Sweden and Switzerland in the top 10 among 180 countries. India slipped the two positions to 80th in the index of the score index with the score 41, while it was 78 in the previous year ranking. Global Talent Competitiveness Index 2020. Global Talent Competitive Index GTCI 2020 has been released at the annual meeting of the World Economic Forum on 22 January 2020. Switzerland emerged as the most talented competitive nation of the world, followed by US and Singapore. India has moved up 8 places to the 72 position out of 132 countries from the 80th position in GTCI 2019. E-Pass launched in Dhaka. The Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, has launched e-passport in Dhaka, Bangladesh on 22 January 2020. With this, Bangladesh has become the first country in South Asia and 190th country in the world to have an e-passport facility. The e-passport will have an embedded chip in theme which will contain a biometric data of the passport holder, a photograph and other information contained in the passport. Askelera Poulou becomes the Greece's first woman president. Greece's parliament has elected the Katrina Sakellaropoulou as the first woman president in the country's history on 22 January 2020. She will succeed the current conservative president Prokopis Pavlopoulos, whose five-year term expires in March. Prior to her election, she served as president of the Council of State, the highest administrative court of Greece. Guyana takes over the championship of G77. The South American country Guyana has took over the championship of the group of 77 G77 for the year 2020 from Palestine. The group of 77 is the largest intergovernmental organization of developing countries in the United Nations. Robert Abela elected new PM of Malta. Malta's governing party has elected a new leader, Robert Abela, as 14th PM and Prime Minister of Malta on 12 January 2020. At the internal party election, he obtained 9,342 votes against the 6,798 votes for his rival Chris Fierne. He replaced the Joseph Muscat, who resigned in December 2019. Henley Passport Index 2020. Henley and Partners has released the Henley Passport Index 2020 on 8 January 2020. Japan emerged the world's most powerful passport, while Singapore took the second spot, followed by South Korea and Germany. India's rank has dropped 82 in 2019 to 84 in 2020, which means that the Indian passport allows visa-free entry to 58 destinations worldwide. Nigeria passport ranked 199 as the weakest passport in the world. Pedro Sanchez re-elected as the PM of Spain. Pedro Sanchez purged Castejón, a Spanish politician and a socialist leader, has been re-elected as Spanish Prime Minister on 7th January 2020. He has also been Secretary General of Spanish Socialist Worker Party, PSOE, since June 2017. Palau becomes first country to be banned reef toxic sunscreen. Palau has become the first country in the world to ban various types of sunscreen to protect the coral reef on 1st January 2020. The sun cream consists of oxybenzone and octinoxate, absorb ultraviolet ray, which causes the water more acidic, makes the coral susceptible to bleaching and agitating fish stocks. WHO designated 2020 as the year of nurse and midwife. World Health Organization has designated the year 2020 as the year of nurse and midwife in honors to the 200th birth anniversary of Florence Nightingale. The year 2020 is significant for WHO in the context of nursing and midwifery strengthening for universal health coverage. The WHO also launched the first ever state of the world's nursing report in 2020 prior to the 73rd session of the World Health Assembly. China launched the Xinjiang 2020 satellite. China has launched its heaviest and most advanced communication satellite, Xinjiang 20, by its largest new carrier rocket Long March 5 from Wenchang Space Launch Center in South China's Hainan province on 27 December 2019. The Long March 5 rocket can carry a maximum payload of 25 tons into low Earth orbit and 15 tons into geosynchronous orbit. Donald Trump launched the U.S. Space Force. U.S. President Trump officially has launched the U.S. Space Force, the first U.S. military service in over the 70 years, focusing on warfare in space on 22 December 2019. He has signed the 2020 National Defense Authorization Act, authorizing the establishment of a Space Force. East-West African country. Eight West African countries renamed common currency. Eight West African nations have agreed to change the name of their common currency from CFA franc to ECO on 22 December 2019. CFA franc is the name of the two countries. The West African CFA franc, which is used in the eight West African countries, and Central African CFA franc, which is used in six Central African countries. Global Gender Gap Report 2020. World Economic Forum WEF has released the Global Gender Gap Index 2020 in December 17 December 2019 under the report Mind the 100 Year Gap. India has been reached 112th among 153 countries. The report analyzed 153 countries in their progress toward the gender parity, focusing on four main dimensions: economic participation and opportunity, educational attainment, health and survival, and political empowerment. UK general election 2019. Boris Johnson won the United Kingdom general election after his Conservative Party crossed the required majority of 326 votes for the 650-seat in the House of Commons on the 13 December 2019. The Labour Party, headed by Jeremy Bernard Corbyn, and the Scottish National Party, headed by Nicola Ferguson Sturgeon, gained 203 and 43 votes respectively. US shutdown, WTO appeal court. The appeal court of the World Trade Organization that acts the trade dispute settlement body for the members was shut down by the United States on 9 December 2019. Without WTO's appellate body, the dispute settlement will return to pre-1995 GATT General Agreement on Tariffs and Trade status quo. Human Development Index 2019. Norway topped the Human Development Index HDI 2019. According to the Human Development Report released by the United Nations Development Programme UNDP on 8 December 2019, Switzerland and Ireland stood at the second and third place respectively out of 198 countries. India has jumped one place from 2018 to 129 in 2019 in HDI. Thank you.